turn toward the children, God, we're asking in this time, in this season, God, where we are so lacking in fathers, we're asking, God, would you mark men and women this day in Uganda? Would you awaken their heart? Would you let them see these lost, these fatherless, these orphan children as you see them? God, would you give them a glimpse of the destiny and the purpose that you have for each child? Would you mark their hearts that they would contend for, that they would contend for in the place of prayer, that they would give themselves to see this generation move from a place of brokenness and destitute to a place of restoration, a place where the destiny of every child is realized, that every child that you've purposed to be an intercessor, a worship leader, an apostolic voice, a prophetic voice, God, we're asking, would you raise up fathers and mothers that will see this generation restored, that will see the destiny of every one of these children realized, and that the nation of Uganda would no longer be known for its violence, for its brokenness, but the pearl of Africa would shine with the radiance of Christ, that Jesus would be Lord over that nation, and that this fatherless and broken generation would be the avenue in which the light of the gospel would shine, in which the prophetic voice would go forth and bring restoration to the people and to the nation. God, we're asking, would you truly begin to mark fathers and mothers throughout this nation? Awaken their hearts. Empower them with your spirit, turning their hearts to this broken generation to see the destiny of every fatherless child realized according to your word. So God, in Jesus' name, I'm asking, would you open heaven and in a greater measure pour out your spirit, raising up fathers to the fatherless in the nation of Uganda, in Jesus' name.
Spirit of adoption, come forth.
That you would rest on believers. God, that your anointing would be upon every congregation. God, I ask that you would raise up laborers and evangelists today. God, we declare that our help and our hope and our strength comes from feasting, from gazing, from meditating, from looking to you as our portion and as our help. So, Father, as we look to you, We find our strength in your glorious throne, in your sovereign dwelling place above the earth. We find our strength today as we look to you, sovereign, high and lifted up. We find our strength even as Isaiah saw the temple in the train of your robe, which filled the temple, the holy angels crying out before your throne. God, we look to you in your very dwelling place. We ask that you would pour out your power and your presence and your Holy Spirit, that you would anoint messengers, that you would cause men and women to find strength in the overcoming power of who you are. We declare that you are the living God, and we pray today for the fatherless in Uganda to be saved. We ask that the word of God would run swiftly. We pray for a sanctifying work with every member in your church all over the nation of Uganda. Father, would you release revival? Would you open the heavens? Would you cause trembling? Would you cause fear? Would you cause worship to break out in this nation? We ask that you would make yourself visible, that you would make yourself known in this nation, that you would captivate many hearts. We declare your power. We declare that you are unchallenged and sovereign over every continent, every nation. And we declare that Uganda is the inheritance of Yahweh, is the inheritance of your Son. We ask today, God, that you would tear down, by the power of your Spirit, arguments, ancestral worship, false ideologies, and that you would exalt the gospel of the living God, the beauty of the cross, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that the word of the Lord would run swiftly and be glorified in Jesus' name.
Lift high the name of Jesus Christ. Let it bring healing and restoration.
With power, let it go forth.
I pray that your power would go forth.
Manifest your presence.
That your word would go forth. Yes, your power, God, we ask for your Spirit. Would you release the big dreams of your heart for the old?
Father, we just ask, would your salvation go forth? God, we just pray for salvation in Uganda. God, we pray that men and women, orphan, fatherless, would be saved. God, we just pray today that your people would humble themselves and seek you. We thank you for the simplicity of wholehearted love. God, we ask today that you would release anointing and healing in Uganda. God, we pray for the sick, that they would be recovered, that they would be healed. Greater works than these, your word declares. We ask that over those laboring for the gospel, that they would have a taste of this reality, of the greater works, that they would move in power, that demonstrations of the living God would be expressed through the church in Uganda. Father, we look before you now on behalf of those that are fatherless, those that are lost. Would your salvation go forth? God, we know that the God of this age has blinded many, but we pray today from this house that blindness would go, that sickness would go, that darkness would be pushed back, and that your light and that your truth, your peace, your love, and your ways would be exalted in Uganda. So we pray in the name of Jesus that your word would run swiftly.
Let it prevail, let it prevail. On your messengers, we pray.
Let it be the God of miracles, signs and wonders.
And at the hearing of your word, you would release your power.
Pour out your spirit, we pray. Your power in Uganda.
Power in
Pour
Uganda.
Out your spirit, Lord. Open up the heavens, we pray.
Pour out your spirit, Lord.
Your power in Uganda.
Pour out your spirit, Lord.
Psalm 68, verses 5 and 6. Father to the fatherless, defender of the widows, this is God, whose dwelling is holy. God places the lonely in families. He sets the prisoners free and gives them joy. God, we thank you for Uganda. We thank you for your church in that land and in all of Africa. But Lord, we thank you that you've chosen Uganda to be a sign and a wonder to the nations, that the spirit of adoption is alive again in the land, that you are turning the hearts of fathers to children and children to fathers. Lord, we thank you for the church that has been through so much in that land, and we ask now that you would give them a vision, a picture of who you are, that they would know that you are God, the defender of widows, the father to the fatherless, that it would be so clear in the minds and in the hearts of your church in Uganda that they would not stop until all the orphans are brought into a home. Lord, that the church would lead the way in that land and that they would be a sign and a wonder to every nation that you are alive, that you are the God of wonders and miracles, and you do not stop until the oppressed are set free. You do not stop until the orphans are brought into your family. You are a father. You are declaring it now in the nations, and we ask that you would declare your name in Uganda, that you would rise up, oh God, declare your name to your enemies, Lord, to that spirit of bondage, and loneliness, Lord, the heaviness that brings orphans down, Lord, that you would break in with your power, declare your name, and wake up your church in Uganda in Jesus' name.
Declare your name.
tried to say that you are something that you are not, Lord. We've tried to, for our own gain, our own selfish gain, use your words for ourselves, Lord. We repent on behalf of the church, Lord, that you would give us a clear vision again of who you are in your holy habitation. God, would you wake up the church across the nations that you are a father. You are a father and you are searching out and seeking out the lost. Lord, that we would lay down our own dreams and visions for ministry and grandeur, Lord, that we would lay it down for the kingdom, for your will to be done on earth, God. We need an awakening in the church. We ask that you would forgive us for living for our own selfish gain, that you would give us a vision